Sergey Kislyak, Russian ambassador to the United States, having a third undisclosed meeting with Attorney General Jeff Sessions. Now, it's worth noting the Senate Intelligence Committee has been looking into this issue, according to sources. It's also reviewing the Justice Department, where Jeff Sessions currently works, says and has said repeatedly a third meeting in April of last year did not actually occur. But Jeff Sessions will testify publicly next week in the Senate. Different debate, but certainly these questions can be well come up. And when it comes to the Senate Intelligence Committee, guys, it's worth noting, again, while this was a very, very big hearing yesterday, they are still very hard at work. They obviously got documents submitted from five national security advisors like this. And next week, they will meet with Bob Holden to discuss how to conflict their investigations and also, according to some members, to discuss those memos that Jim Comey talked about, had his testimony about, and has given to Bob Holden that members also want to see. And guys, one more crucial element here and one more big name. Jared Kushner, as soon as next week, will be behind closed doors with Senate Intelligence Committee staff. Now, there are a number of issues that Senate investigators have been looking into related to Jared Kushner, his role in the campaign's digital operation, his relationship with Fire National Security Advisor Michael Flynn, and also reports that he worked to set up a back channel with Russian officials. Now, Jared Kushner's lawyers have been very clear. He's happy to speak with anybody whenever they can set that up. And that looks like he'll be coming to bear next week, talking to Senate Intelligence investigating staff. Now, what happens next after that? Well, according to sources, we will then submit documents. Well, we'll be requested to submit personal documents. Then, after that, he would meet with Senate Intelligence Committee members, the Senate and senators themselves. Now, the big question, guys, is will any of this be public? At this point, that's unclear. But this idea that things came to an end yesterday, or yesterday was kind of a big finish to things, it just isn't accurate. There's a lot of steps to come, and that's just in Congress, not to mention the federal investigation that's still ongoing. So, guys, a lot to pay attention to. Keep a very close eye on Capitol Hill next week. This investigation is still moving forward, full bore. Both Republicans and Democrats on the committee have made that clear.
It means you, Phil Mattingly, don't get a day off for a really long time, by the way. Thank you for the reporting. Joining us now is our panel, David Swerdlick is a CNN political commentator and assistant editor for the Washington Post, Lena Zito, a CNN contributor and reporter for the Washington Examiner, Earl Lewis, CNN political commentator and political anchor for Spectrum News, and Paul Callen, our CNN legal analyst extraordinaire and senior trial counsel for Callen Legal. So, counselor, to you, is this all just from our captains? Because we're just looking at some of the guidance here. The Department of Justice has limited jurisdiction over a former employee. The most they can do is note it in his files. And you're not working on it.
You know, probably. I'm not surprised that that's aggressively going after him.
James Comey in his testimony yesterday is accusing the former FBI director of perjury.